Jai Hind, dear students, and my dear friends. Today we are moving to another chapter from Accounting for Partnership, that is Reconstitution of Partnership Firm, Admission of a Partner, Admission of a New Partner into the Firm. So you know very well, a new partner is admitted at the time, they have to change the agreements, everything. They have to create a new partnership deed. When a firm requires additional capital or managerial help, or for both, the expansion of its business, the old partners will bring a new partner into the firm. Maybe for increasing the capital, or for managerial help, or for the expansion of their business, they will appoint a new, they will admit a new partner, that is admission of a new partner. And it is as per the Partnership Act of 1932. A new partner can be admitted into the firm only with the consent of other partners, only with the consent of remaining partners or old partners. They can bring, one partner can bring, or the whole partner can bring a new partner into the firm. With the admission of a new partner, the partnership firm is reconstituted. They are changing their agreement. They are creating a new agreement and continuing their business by admitting a new partner. So that is the concept regarding admission of a new partner. Maybe for increasing the capital, amount of capital, or for managerial purpose, or for the expansion, opening new branches for the business, they need capital fund. At that time, they will admit a new partner, and the new partner will bring goodwill and capital. So, at the time of admission of a new partner, he have two rights. Right to share the asset of the partnership firm. Once the partner is admitted, with the permission of other partners, the newly admitted partner have the right to share the assets of the partnership firm. And that partner have the right to share the profit also. Not only sharing assets, but also he or she is eligible to share the profit of the firm also. The partner brings an agreed amount of capital, maybe in cash or in the form of goods. Every time the newly admitted partner have to bring capital as well as amount of goodwill. Moreover, in the case of an established firm which may be earning more profit than the normal rate of return on its capital, the new partner is required to contribute some additional amount known as premium or goodwill. So those firms earning super profit, that is more than the normal rate of return, more than the normal profit, if they are earning such an amount, they have to contribute an amount additional along with the capital, that is known as premium or goodwill. So, my dear students, please remember, already we have learned how to calculate the amount of goodwill. So, that is the additional amount brought by the new partner into the firm. This is done primarily to compensate the existing partners for the loss of their share in their super profit of the firm. So, when the newly admitted partner enters into the partnership firm, old partners have to sacrifice, surrender a part of their profit in favor of the newly admitted partner. So the amount of goodwill brought by the new partner will be used for compensating the sacrifice made by the old partners. Remember, the amount of goodwill brought by the new partner will be shared to the old partners in their sacrificing ratio. because it is a compensation for the sacrifice made by the old partners for the newly admitted partner. So remember, the two rights of newly admitted partners are right to share the assets as well as right to share the profit of the partnership firm. And we have to remember some more points. Following are the points which are requires attention at the time of admission of a new partner. So remember, my dear students, we are going to calculate new ratio, new profit sharing ratio, because when a new partner is admitted, there will be new agreement needed to run the firm by modifying the old partnership deed. And at that time, in that agreement, they will mention what is the new profit sharing between all the partners after the admission of the new partner. And what is the sacrificing ratio? In this video, you are going to learn how to calculate these two ratios, new profit sharing ratio and the sacrificing ratio. Sacrificing ratio shows the sacrifice made by the old partners, and also the valuation and adjustment of goodwill you will learn from this chapter, and revaluation of assets and reassessment of liability. My dear students, we will learn on account, preparation of an account known as revaluation account. Revaluation of asset and liabilities undertaken to find out the new value for asset and the reassessment value for liability at the time of admission of a new partner. So remember the distribution of accumulated profit also. If there is any accumulated profit which is stored in reserve or as profit, that must be shared in between the partners. That point also you have to remember. Adjustments related to partners' capital. There will be a lot of adjustment, different adjustments related to capital at the time of admission of a new partner by changing their profit sharing ratio also. So remember all these points which we have to consider at the time of admission of partner. We have to solve more problems related to all these areas. So remember all these headings. My dear students, we are going to learn how to calculate new profit sharing ratio. And we have to remember what is the need of calculating the new profit sharing ratio. Normally, when the partnership firm is reconstituted, at the time of admitting a new partner, the existing ratio is changed because the newly partner have to share profit along with the old partners. So in partnership deed, there will be a change in the new profit sharing ratio. But we have to calculate what will be the new profit sharing ratio. Suppose some portion of the profit is given for the newly admitted partner. So we have to learn through different cases by solving different problems how to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. So at the time of admission of a new partner, the old partners sacrifices a share of their profit in favor of the newly admitted partner. After they admit the new partner, sharing of profit will be as per the calculated new profit sharing ratio. But what will be the share of new partner and how he will acquire it from the existing partner is decided mutually among the old partner and the new partner. So every time the partner, maybe old partner and the newly admitted partner, will conduct a meeting and decide how to share the profit in future after the admission of the new partner. So that is what it is very important and relevant to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. So, my dear students, we are going to solve one problem to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. So, remember the different cases. The first case is when only the ratio of new partner is given in the question. How to calculate the new profit sharing ratio? So, few steps are there. Remember the situation when only the new ratio of new partner, the ratio of new partner is given in the question, how to calculate the new profit sharing ratio? That is the case. So, only the share of new partner is given. How to calculate the profit sharing ratio, new profit sharing ratio? So, remember the different steps to be followed at this stage. We have to take the total profit of the firm after the admission of the new partner. Total profit of the firm after the admission of the new partner as 1. We are assuming and calculating the ratio. So, we have to assume that the total profit of the firm after the admission of the new partner is 1. Then, the remaining share, after giving, after providing the share of profit for the newly admitted partner, what is the remaining share? After providing the share of newly admitted partner, what is the remaining share we have to calculate? The remaining share will be shared by the old partners in their old profit sharing ratio. That is the method to solve the problem. When only the new partner's share is given, older ratio is given, but only the new partner's share is given, how to calculate? So, we have to take the total profit as 1. Total profit of the firm after the admission of the new partner is 1. Then we have to calculate the remaining share. Suppose a newly admitted partner is taken for 1 by 4th share of profit, the remaining share will be 1 minus 1 by 4. So, we will get 3 by 4 as the remaining share, and it will be shared by the old partners in their old profit sharing ratio, or existing ratio. So, the next step we have to remember, we have to calculate the old partner's new share. So, remaining share will be calculated, then we have to calculate the old partner's new share. So, their old share into the remaining share, we will get the old partner's new share. So, remember the steps, we have to take the total profit as 1, we are assuming like that. Then we are finding out the remaining share of profit for old partners. After sharing for the new partner, what is the amount remaining as profit that can be shared by the old partners in their old sharing ratio? So, when we are calculating their old partners' new share, we have to multiply their old share with the remaining share. My dear students, we are going to solve one problem. To know more about and to collect the practical experience regarding how to calculate the amount of net profit. So, look at this illustration. Here, two partners are there, Anju and Vrinda. Their profit sharing ratio is 3:2. That means their old ratio before the admission of the new partner Sunidha, their old ratio is 3:2. So, remember their old ratio is 3:2. And they admitted Sunidha as a new partner for 1 by 5th share in the future profit. We have to calculate the profit sharing ratio, new profit sharing ratio. So, only the 1 by 5th share is given. The newly admitted partner's share is given. But nothing is told about how she is getting the 1 by 5th share. Nothing is mentioned about how the Sunidha is getting 1 by 5th share. So, we have to follow the steps that we have learned in the theoretical area. So, remember the question, old ratio is 3:2. That means 3:2 means for Anju 3 by 5, for Vrinda 2 by 5 and the newly admitted partners share 1 by 5. So just look at this solution. We are taking the total profit as 1. The total profit of the firm after admission of Sunidha is 1. Then what is the remaining share? Remaining share means after giving the Sunidha's portion 1 by 5, what is remaining there? That can be distributed for the old partners, Anju and Vrinda. So remaining share will be calculated like this. 1 minus the newly admitted partner's share. 1 minus the newly admitted partner's share 1 by 5. So I think you know very well the mathematical calculation. 1 minus 1 by 5 is equal to 4 by 5. 4 by 5. So out of 5, 1 is for the newly admitted partner Sunidha. Then what is remaining? Out of 5, 1 is for Sunidha. Then remaining is 4. Out of 5, 4 is remaining for the newly admitted partner. Then we have to use the next step. Old partner's new share is equal to old share into remaining share. Old share into remaining share. So the Anju's new share is equal to her old share 3 by 5 into remaining share 4 by 5. Once again, Anju's old share is 3 by 5. 3 by 5 means 3 is to 2. 3 plus 2, 5. 3 by 5 into their remaining share 4 by 5 is equal to 12 by 25. So Anju's new share is 12 by 25. Then what about Vrinda's new share? Like the same. Her old share 2 by 5 into the remaining share 4 by 5. We will get 8 by 25. 2 into 4, 8. 5 into 5, 25. So we got the new share for Anju and Vrinda. Then we have to calculate. Then we have to just arrange what is the new profit sharing ratio. So new share of partners is equal to for Anju 12 by 25. 12 by 25. This is the value. Then for Vrinda, new share 8 by 25. Written here. And for Sunidha, her share is 1 by 5. When we are equalizing the denominator, 5 into 5, 25. 1 into 5, 5. So when we are equalizing the denominators, 1 by 5 will be 5 by 25. So the new profit sharing ratio between these three partners is 12 is to 8 is to 5. 12 is to 8 is to 5. My dear students, in this way, we have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio of the new three partners, the new partnership firm. I hope it is very clear for you. We have to calculate like this if the newly admitted partner's share is given. Only that amount is given, then we have to do like this. We have to remember all these steps. It is very essential for the next topic, calculation of sacrificing ratio also. So please remember the calculation of new profit sharing ratio if only the partner, newly admitted partner's share is given, but nothing is mentioned about how to share that profit. Okay, then we are moving to another problem. Another case. Sometimes the new partner purchases his share of profit from old partners equally. Sometimes the new partner purchases his share of profit from old partners equally. He gets some profit, part of the profit from old partners. They are sacrificing equally. They are surrendering some portion for the new partner equally. Then what we have to do? So in this case, the new profit sharing ratio of old partners will be calculated by deducting the share of profit given by them to the new partner from the old profit sharing ratio. So the new ratio is equal to old share of profit minus what is the amount deducted, what is the amount deducted given for the newly admitted partner. So remember, you have to follow one step. Old partners, new profit sharing ratio is equal to old share minus share surrendered. Surrendered means given or sacrificed by the new by the old partner for new partner. So old share minus share surrendered by the old partners for new partner. Remember the equation. Then we have to solve one problem. Here Vishnu and Shiva are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 5:3. They admitted Brahma as the new partner for 1/16th share. 1/16th share. So old ratio is 5:3. New partner's share is 1/16th, which he earns equally from old partners. So he, Brahma, is getting this share equally from Vishnu and Shiva, which he earns equally from old partners in their future profit of the firm. We have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. So both are giving equal share out of 1/16 for the newly admitted partner. Then how it will be calculated? So Brahma's share is 1/16. Then we have to divide it equally. So share given by Vishnu to Brahma is equal to 1/2 of 1/16, because both partners are sharing the sacrifice made for the Brahma equally. So 1/2 of 1/16 is equal to 1/32. The same amount will be given by Shiva also. So share given by Shiva to Brahma, same calculation, 1/2 of 1/16, that is 1/32. So we got the value, what is the amount sacrificed by the, surrendered by the old partners for the newly admitted partner, that is 1/32 and 1/32. Then we have to calculate the new share of partners. Vishnu's new share is equal to 3/8 minus 1/32. 3/8 minus their old share minus what is given for the newly admitted partner, 1/32. So we will get 19/32 for Vishnu's new share. And what is Shiva's new share? Like the same, old ratio minus what he is surrendered for Brahma. So 3/8 minus 1/32, 11/32 is the answer. Please remember the steps. Then we have to arrange the new profit sharing ratio. So remember, first we have to find out the equal share sacrificed by the old partners for newly admitted partner. And then we have to deduct the new share from their old share. Then for Vishnu, 19/32. For Shiva, 11/32. And for Brahma, to equalize the denominator, 32, 16 into 2, you will get 32. So 2/32. And the new profit sharing ratio will be 19:11:2. Hope it is very clear. Dear students, we are moving to the third case in the calculation of new profit sharing ratio. So in the last case, we have learned how to find out the profit sharing ratio, the new profit sharing ratio, if the old partners surrenders or sacrifices the profit share equally for the newly admitted partner. But in the third case, the new partner purchases his share of profit from old partners in a particular ratio. The second case, the share is purchased by the new partner equally from old partners, but here they collect, that person, the new partner, will purchase his share from old partners in a particular ratio. So we have to find out the new profit sharing ratio in the same way only we have to deduct what is the surrendered share by the old partners from their old share. It will be a different ratio. So it will be very clear when you solve this problem. So here Vishnu and Shiva are partners sharing profit in losses ratio 7:3, and also we have to find out the share. They admitted Brahma as a new partner for 3/9 share, which he earned 2/9 from Vishnu. So 2/9 out of 3/9, 2/9 is given by Vishnu and 1/9 given by Shiva. So he earned share 2/9 from Vishnu and 1/9 from Shiva. Calculate the new profit sharing ratio. So the sacrifice made by the old partner is different. Here the sacrifice made by the old partner is different. So that is the third case. How to calculate the new profit sharing ratio? So this is the solution. Old partner given, they are given contribution, the 3/9 is the new ratio, new partner's share. 3/9 is the new partner's share. Then Vishnu new share is equal to nothing else. It's very simple. Vishnu's old share 7/10. 7:3. 7 + 3, 10. So out of 10, 7 is for Vishnu minus what Vishnu surrenders for Brahma. That is 2/9. So we will get 43/90 as Vishnu's new share. So remember, 7/10 is the old share. What Vishnu surrender for the new partner, that is 2/9. We are deducting the surrender value from old ratio. We will get 43/90. Then we have to find out like the same for Shiva also. What is Shiva's new share? Old share 3/10 minus the amount sacrificed by Shiva for the newly admitted partner Brahma. That is 1/9. So old ratio minus the surrendered share 1/9 is equal to 17/90. And new profit sharing of these three partners is 43/90 for Vishnu and for Shiva 17/90. And Brahma's share, when it is equalizing, the denominators are equalizing, 3/9 is equal to 30/90. And the new profit sharing ratio will be 43:17:30. So it is very simple in this problem. No need to calculate the sacrificed share. It is directly given 2/9 and 1/9. It is deducted from their old ratio. Then we will get the remaining share. My dear students, we are moving to the next case. Sometimes the old partners surrender particular fraction of their share in favor of new partner. Particular fraction means some portion of share from their, some portion of their share of profit, some portion of their share of profit in favor of the new partner. Then we have to calculate what is the some portion, some fraction of their share which is surrendered for the newly admitted partner. So here we have to find out the sacrificed value first, sacrificed amount of per share of profit first. Then we have to deduct it from their old ratio. So remember, in this case the new profit sharing ratio of old partners will be calculated by deducting the share of profit given by them to the new partner from their old share of profit. And new partner's share is calculated by adding the surrendered shares of old partners. So remember, we are calculating the new partner's share by adding what is sacrificed by the old partners. So the new old partners, new ratio calculation is very simple. Old ratio minus share surrendered for new partner. It's very clear from this problem here. Baiju and Shiju are partners sharing profit in the ratio of 5:3. They admitted Viju as a new partner. Biju sacrifices 3/5 of his share of profit. 3/5 of his share of profit. And Shiju 1/5 share of his share of profit. Of his share of profit for Viju. We have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. So some portion of profit is there for Viju, and out of that amount, he is sacrificing 3/5 of that amount. 3/5 of that amount for Viju. And also Shiju have some amount of profit. Shiju sacrifices 1/5 of his share of profit. 1/5 of share. It's not, the sacrifice is not 1/5. It is some portions, some portion profit is there. That profits 1/5 is surrendered by Shiju for Viju. So please go through the steps. First, we have to find out the sacrifice value of profit by all the partners. So Biju's sacrifice is equal to his share. His share here, it is very given. His old share 5:3. Biju sacrifices 3/5. So look at here. Biju's sacrifice is equal to 5:3. 5/8 into his share of sacrifice. Out of 5/8, Biju sacrifices 3/5 portion for Viju. So 5/8 into 3/5. So we will get 15/40. 15/40 or 3/8. Like the same, we have to find out Shiju's sacrifice. So his old share 3/8. Out of that, 1/5 is shared. Out of that, 1/5 is shared for the newly admitted partner. So here 3/40. 3 × 1, 3, 8 × 5, 40. So we got the sacrificed value of profit by the old partners. Then we have to apply the formula old share minus share surrender to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. So Biju's new share is equal to his old share 5/8 minus 15/40, or the sacrifice made by Biju, that is 15/40. So 5/8 minus 15/40 is equal to 10/40. We will get the value by equalizing 40. No need to calculate the LCM. To equalize 8 × 40, we have to multiply 5 × 8 and 5 × 5. So 25/40 minus 15/40 is equal to 10/40. And also, Shiju's new share is equal to his old share 3/8. 3/8 minus 3/40. The sacrifice made by Shiju. 3/8 minus 3/40, we will get the amount 12/40. We will get the value 12/40. So Biju's new share 10/40, Shiju's new share 12/40. And what is the new share of Biju? It will be the total of Biju's and Shiju's sacrifice. So next we have to calculate what is Biju's share of profit. So we will get the amount sacrificed by Biju, 15/40. 15/40 plus what is sacrificed by Shiju, 3/40. 3/40. So 3/40 will be added to 15/40. We will get 18/40. 18/40 is the new share of profit for Viju. Then we have to write separately 10/40 is to 12 by 40 is to 18 by 40. We will get the new profit sharing ratio as 10 is to 12 is to 18. That is the share of profit, new share of profit of the firm after the admission of Viju. My dear students, these are the different cases, four different cases related to calculation of new profit sharing ratio. So hope it is very clear for you. We are moving to the calculation of sacrificing ratio. Calculation of sacrificing ratio. So sacrificing ratio shows the amount surrendered by the old partners in favor of the new partner. Sacrificing ratio, it shows the ratio which shows the amount surrendered or sacrificed or given by the old partner to the new partner. The ratio in which the old partners agreed to sacrifice their share of profit in favor of the incoming partner is called sacrificing ratio. The sacrifice by a partner is equal to old share of profit minus new share of profit. Old share of profit minus new share of profit is the rule or the formula for calculating sacrificing ratio. My dear students, please remember the equation old ratio minus new ratio. Old share of profit minus new share of profit, or old ratio minus new ratio, is the equation for calculating sacrificing ratio. So we have to go to the illustrations. First, I am taking the same problem that we have taken for calculating new profit sharing ratio. Here, it is very easy. From the same problem, we can find out the sacrificing ratio also. My dear students, you have to remember the equation old ratio minus new ratio. So, in this question, we have calculated the share of profit by taking the total profit as 1. Then we have calculated the remaining share of profit, 1 minus 1 by 5 is 2, 4 by 5. Then we have calculated the old partner's new profit share. Anju's new share is equal to her old share, 3 by 5 into 4 by 5 is equal to 12 by 25. Then Vrinda's new share, 2 by 5 into 4 by 5, 8 by 25. Then we have written the new sharing ratio, 12 by 25 is to 8 by 25 is to 5 by 25. So the new ratio is to 12 is to 8 is to 5. So we have the new ratio 12 is to 8 is to 5 and the old ratio 3 is to 2. 3 is to 2. So we can directly apply in the equation old share minus new share to find out the value of sacrificing ratio. So sacrificing of Anju. Anju's sacrifice is equal to old share 3 by 5. 3 by 5. That is here 3 by 5 minus her new share. Anju's new share 12 by 25. So 3 by 5 minus 12 by 25. Then we will get the value of shares sacrificed by Anju, 3 by 25. Remember, old share minus new share, sacrifice of Anju is equal to 3 by 25. The same way we have to calculate the sacrifice of Vrinda also. Not Anju, here Vrinda. Vrinda also we have to calculate Vrinda's sacrifice also. So Vrinda's sacrifice is equal to her 2 by 5 is her old share minus 8 by 25. 8 by 25 Vrinda's new share. So 2 by 5 minus 8 by 25 is equal to 2 by 25. 2 by 25. Vrinda's old share 2 by 5 minus her new share 8 by 25. Then we will get 2 by 25 as the value. And the final answer, sacrificing ratio is equal to 3 by 25 is to 2 by 25 means 3 is to 2. 3 is to 2. I hope it is very clear for you. Then we are moving to another problem. The second problem we have done while calculating the new ratio. Here Vishnu and Shiva are partners sharing profits in the ratio 5:3. They admitted Brahma as a new partner for 1/16 the share of profit which he earns equally from all the partners. We have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio and the sacrificing ratio. Here 1/16 is the new partner's share. The share given by Vishnu to Brahma. The older partners are sharing equally. So half of 1/16 given by Vishnu and half of 1/16 is given by Shiva. So half of 1/16 is equal to 1/32. The another half given by Shiva is also 1/32. So the amount of profit, the share of profit surrendered by Vishnu 1/32 and Shiva is 1/32. So as per that we have calculated Vishnu's new share, old share minus the surrendered share 1/32, old share 5/8 minus the share, surrendered share 1/32 is equal to 19/32, and also Shiva's new share 11/32. Then we have written the new share of partners 19/32 is to 11/32 is to 2/32. 2/32 already we have calculated the values. So 19 is to 11 is to 2 is the answer for new profit sharing ratio. But we have to calculate the sacrifice. But it is very simple. From the question is itself we can find out, because the amount given by Vishnu means the amount sacrificed by Vishnu, or the amount given by Shiva means the amount surrendered, sacrificed or given by Shiva to Brahma. So 1:1. From this question it's very easy to calculate the sacrificing ratio. Why? Because the amount given by both the partners are equal. So 1:1 is the sacrificing ratio. I hope it is very clear. Surrendered ratio, surrendered share, sacrificing ratio shows the surrendered share for the by the old partners for the newly admitted partner. So here in this problem, Vishnu given half of the 1/16, Shiva given half of 1/16. So that given half means 1:1. That is here. We can use the formula also. So the Brahma's share, we can use the formula old ratio minus new ratio. Old share of Vishnu and Shiva 5:3. New share of three partners 19:11:2. Then old ratio minus new ratio. Sacrifice of Vishnu is equal to old ratio 5/8 minus new ratio 19/32. So when we equalize 5 into 4, 20 minus 19 1/32, 1/32 for Vishnu, and also sacrifice by Shiva, old share 3/8 minus new share 11/32. So 3/8 minus 11/32, 1/32. 12 minus 11 1/32. So it's very easy. Already we have written in that area that 1:1 is the sacrificing ratio. So it is very clear, and it is very simple to calculate problem like this, the value of sacrificing ratio when they are sharing equally, old partners are sharing equally, then the sacrificing ratio will be equal. Remember that value point also. My dear students, we are taking the third problem in the calculation of new profit sharing ratio to find out sacrificing ratio. Vishnu and Shiva are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 7:3. They admitted Brahma as a new partner for 3/9, which he earned 2/9 from Vishnu and 1/9 from Shiva in the future profits. We have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio and the sacrificing ratio. So the old partners given two different values, two different proportions of share of profit. So we have calculated Vishnu's new share like this. What old share minus what is the surrendered share, 43/90, and Shiva's new share 3/10, old share minus the surrendered share 1/9, 17/90. Then we have written the new profit sharing ratio like 43:17:30. 43:17:30. So the new profit sharing ratio is 43:17:30. But we have to calculate sacrificing ratio also. Actually, what they given? Vishnu given 2/9, Shiva given 1/9. So it's very simple. 2:1 is the sacrificing ratio. 2:1 is the sacrificing ratio by the old partners. But we have to use the formula old ratio minus new ratio. So sacrifice of Vishnu is equal to old ratio 7/10. 7/10 minus his new share. Vishnu's new share is 43/90. So 7/10 minus 43/90, we will get 20/90 as the value of sacrifice of Vishnu. Then we have to find out the sacrifice of Shiva also. So old ratio 3/10, 3/10 minus new ratio 17/90. 17/90. So 3/10 minus 17/90, then we will get the value 10/90. So what is the sacrificing ratio? 2:1. 20/90:10/90. 20:10. Then we can write 2:1 is the sacrificing ratio. 2:1 means 2/9:1/9. It is also very easy to find out the value of sacrificing ratio from these type of problems. We are moving to the last problem, fourth problem from the new profit sharing ratio calculation. Here we have to find out the value of sacrifice also. So some portion of the old partner's share is given for the new partner. So Biju's sacrifice 3/5 of his share, and Shiju sacrifice 1/5 of his share, and we have used the same methods. Biju's sacrifice is equal to his old share 5/8 × 3/5. So Biju sacrifice 15/40, and Shiju's sacrifice 3/8 × 1/5, 3/40. We have calculated everything, the sacrifice by both partners. So we can directly write there 15:3, 5:1 as the sacrificing ratio. But again, we are applying the equation old ratio minus new ratio. For that, we have to find out the new ratio. So Biju's new share is equal to his old share 5/8 minus what he have surrendered 15/40. 5/8 minus 15/40 is equal to 10/40. Biju's new share. And what is for Shiju? 3/8 minus 3/40. We will get 12/40 as the new share. So remember, what is the difference? What is the different value? And also, we have to find out the Biju's share by adding 15/40 plus 3/40, the sacrificed shares. 18/40 is the new profit sharing ratio of new partner. Biju's share 18/40. Then we will write a new profit sharing ratio is equal to 10:12:18. 10:12:18. So new profit sharing ratio is here, and old profit sharing ratio is equal to 5:3. Then we have to find out the sacrifice. We can directly write 15/40:3/40, 15:3. That means 5:1 is the sacrificing ratio. So remember, these are not the different problems related to calculation of new profit sharing ratio and sacrificing ratio. My dear students, it is very important. Every year there will be one question for 3 mark or maybe for 4 mark for the calculation of ratios, especially new ratio, sacrificing ratio. Upcoming chapters have gaining ratio also. So my dear students, please keep in mind, it's very important for the preparation of final accounts related to admission of partner also. My dear students, I hope it is very clear for you all the concept I had taught today. Please remember one thing, you can develop the concept in a direct way by solving more and problem from the textbooks, and also by watching video again and again, you will get a clear cut picture regarding the calculation of new ratio and sacrificing ratio. We will meet in the next video. Till then, bye bye. Thank you so much.